friends. I'm Pastor Diana.
Welcome to a daily devotion. I'm so glad you've paused during your day to spend some time with God, reflect upon scripture, and that I get to spend this time with you. It's great to be with you. Today, we are continuing our theme of the wandering and considering how rituals are so important in our lives. As we are journeying with the Israelites during their wandering in the wilderness and beyond. And so one of the things I want us to think about today is what are the ceremonies and the symbols that are so important to us in our wanderings and how they help ground us and keep us centered. Our scripture lesson today comes from the book of Joshua. And so it's actually as the Israelites are moving into the promised land, they are crossing the Jordan. And then this is what they do. The Israelites did exactly what Joshua ordered. They lifted 12 stones from the middle of the Jordan, matching the number of the tribes of the Israelites, exactly as the Lord had said to Joshua. They brought them over to the camp and put them down there. Joshua also set up 12 stones in the middle of the Jordan, where the feet of the priests had stood while carrying the covenant chest. They are still there today. Ceremonies and rituals. So I love this story of what the Israelites do and how God is calling them to remember, to create ceremonies and rituals with the 12 stones about what it meant for them to cross the Jordan. And so they did one that they all experienced together, and then they did one as a memory. And I think that that is so important for us as a community, to think about these symbols and these ceremonies that help us in our lives. Perhaps for you, it might be a once-in-a-lifetime ceremony, such as a wedding or a funeral. Or perhaps it's weekly ceremonies that maybe you do as a family devotion, or some other weekly event. Maybe it's church. Maybe it's remembering your baptism or a baptism. But all of these are so important that they ground us. And that's been something that's been very hard over this pandemic time, is that we have missed out on some of those symbols and those ceremonies that we used to rely on, and we've had to envision them in new ways. And we continue to envision them. But at the core of them, some of the things don't change. You know, when I was thinking about this, I thought of this chalice and this patent, which as a Christian minister, they mean a lot. They symbolize communion. And this is a new one that I just received. On my final day after giving our presentations, all of my friends and my colleagues in our DMIN class, we received a box. And we waited, and they told us, wait till we open it at a certain time, and we opened it together. And this was one of those things in there. Because for many of us, we weren't going to graduation, not all of us would, we weren't all together, and so we missed some of the ceremony and ritual. But instead, they gave us the gift of a way to always be connected, to remember that as we engage in ceremonies with God and with others, that we are still connected together at this, with the table and with other rituals. And so I want you to consider, what are the ceremonies, what are the symbols that you have in your life that even though some of the parts of it might have changed over this last year, what are the things that you use to center you and to ground you? And why are they important? And how might they continue to change? And how might they continue to have that symbolic meaning? I hope you'll think about it. Leave me a comment, share it with me, and let's pray. Gracious and loving God, thank you for the ceremonies and the rituals that bind us, that help us to remember you and help us to make meaning in our life. Be with me today as I seek to find you during all my wanderings. Amen. Thank you so much for joining me. Leave a comment below. Tell me what are the ceremonies that are important in your life or have been important. And make sure to share this with someone or tell us that you liked it. And make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel so that you don't miss a single one. I hope that you have a blessed day in all your wanderings.